Tablet chlorination systems are one method of treating agricultural water. A tablet chlorination tank pumps water through chlorine tablets at the proper rate. It's critical that you monitor the pump rate so that water is chlorinated at the right level. If the water is dirty when it goes through the system, it reduces concentration of the available chlorine, so any filtration prior to chlorination will help improve activity. When the system is working correctly, the chlorine tablets will treat the water, so that growers can routinely meet microbiological water quality requirements. You will need to make sure the system is loaded with chlorine tablets and that they are arranged so that the water will be contacting them at the bottom of the sieve plate. Sometimes, gaps occur with the tablets. When this bridging happens, water doesn't get exposed to enough chlorine. Be sure to pack tablets onto the plate to make sure enough pellets are touching the plate. Before touching the tablets, water goes through the flow meter, which tracks the rate the water flows into the system. It continues through to the sieve plate where it touches the bottom of the tablets. Water has to flow through the chlorine tablet for the right length of time, or the concentration of chlorine won't be correct. The free chlorine that's released from the tablets combines with water to form hypochlorous acid. The acid enters the bacteria, causing oxidation of cellular components like enzymes and lowers the internal pH. For cells like E. coli, this means death. At the typically low concentrations used for treating water, chlorine should not raise your pH. You should verify this is the case by monitoring the pH to make sure it stays within the range of 6.5 to 7.5. The float valve and pump prevent the water inside the tank from overflowing and ensure proper contact with the chlorine tablets. When the system works correctly, your water will be consistently treated to inactivate microorganisms. To treat the water in production, you have to validate, monitor, and verify. You validate the system when it is initially installed or when big alterations are made to make sure it is working similarly to what has been shown to be effective by scientists. The manufacturer of the system will be able to provide you with criteria which must be met to consistently treat water. You will also want to check the label for your product to make sure it's used as directed. When validating your chlorination system, these factors will include water flow rates, chlorine contact times, and available or free chlorine concentrations to make sure they match the parameters that have been shown to be effective in scientific studies. After validation, you will need to monitor the system on a regular basis to make sure the critical factors are being controlled and the water is being consistently treated. Examples of monitoring would be ensuring the flow rate is set appropriately, that there are tablets in the chlorinator, and that the appropriate free chlorine concentration is being achieved after treatment. When we monitor our system, it's important to make a record of our observations for other employees of the farm or outside inspectors and auditors to review. Lastly, you will verify that the system works as intended. Examples of verification would be observing the employee monitoring the system, collecting water samples, sending them to the lab for microbiological analysis, and review and document the results that the lab passes along.